You should be honored by my lateness that I even show up to the spaceship. Go ahead, go nuts, go apeshit. Cause I'm 41 looking like I'm 26. Act like you can't tell who made this new gospel, homie. Take six. And take this.
Okay, y'all read this out loud to y'all. Cause it's interesting. It's an interesting read. This was written April 19th, 2008 by Scott Herhold. It's titled, Mix of Porn, Drugs, Violence Leads to Suicide in Morgan Hill Motel. In a first floor room at the Economy Inn in Morgan Hill, the clothed body of porn director Inkyo Volt Hwang, 38 years old, lay face down, half off and half on the bed, an empty box of milk duds near his head. I wonder if the writer realized that that rhymed a little bit. I'm sure they did on purpose. Hwang's body was found September 29th, a few feet from a shrine he constructed to his recently deceased wife, porn starlet Haley Paige, 25 years old. Near two glass candles, he taped three computer-generated photos of Paige smiling and another of her casket. In a spiral notebook, he described how hard it was for him to deal with her death, a death in which police said he was implicated. So, as we continue, this is a cautionary tale as to why, if you're a male, you may want to think twice before getting involved with a porn star. Because the death rate of porn stars is incredibly high, but the death rate of men linked to porn stars and who produce porn is unusually high as well. Early this month, the verdict on Hwang's demise became public. It was no big surprise. The Santa Clara County Coroner's Office said the Canoga Park man had committed suicide by an overdose of methadone pills. Another sordid death in a sordid world? Maybe. As I pulled back the strands of this story, however, I encountered things I did not expect. A father's grief, a daughter's yearning, an unpopular man's penance, and even male chauvinist's compassion. This much seems clear. Hwang and Paige were hellbent for destruction in a life that mixed porn, drugs, and violence in a lethal cocktail. Hwang, sometimes known as Chico Wanker Wang, was a UCLA honors graduate, an erratic ex-con who swore he never could tell his Korean-born parents what he did. Quote, "This was a very dark and dangerous fellow," end quote, said Luke Ford, a freelance writer who knew him. And everyone check out Luke Ford. He used to run a site called lucasback.com. Good man, good man. He's dealt with a lot of the adult entertainment industry turmoil, just as me, when it comes to people trying to get the information that we've accumulated over the years as to the truth of the organized crime elements offline. Never happening. Wang, sometimes known as Chico Wanker Wang, was a UCLA honors graduate, an erratic ex-con who swore he never could tell his Korean-born parents what he did. Quote, "This was a very dark, dangerous fellow," end quote, said Luke Ford, a freelance writer who knew him. He would talk about killing himself and other people with a disturbing ease that wasn't just humor. So this guy was no comedian. He was violent. Sweet and sad. Paige, whose real name was Miriam Haley, came across as sweet and sad, a Woody Guthrie fan, plunged into a world that mocked melody. Born of mixed Mexican and Welsh descent, she grew up in San Diego and worked odd jobs, a Blockbuster clerk, an aide to the Green Party, before drifting into the porn industry. She said she needed money for rent, In online interviews, Paige talked of wanting to travel and study psychology. That sounds like so many porn girls when I think about it. One in particular, a woman known as Christina Pereira. She actually did go to school for psychology. She did. She did, but she wound up mixed up with a real psycho too. A guy known as Ari Bass wanted to take some legalities out in regards to. But yeah, so many women in the adult industry are interested in psychology, and I get why. Because just naturally, when you work in an environment to where, for the most part, if you're a woman, you're entertaining men, you start to really get in touch with the male psyche, and you start to realize, hey, I could be doing this for a living instead of shaking my ass. So adult entertainers out there, think about going into psychology, because you would probably be very good at it if you happen to be a good exotic dancer, because the only way you make money as an exotic dancer or stripper is through hustling, and through hustling, you have to know psychology. Anyway, in online interviews, Paige talked of wanting to travel and study psychology, maybe even having a family someday. When an interviewer asked if she had a motto, she said, quote, "Even a horse that's waiting to be glue needs a little sugar too," end quote. Isn't that dark and tragic? She'd kind of given up already. She saw herself as a horse waiting to become glue. That's sad. Quote, "She was probably looking for someone to take charge of her life," said Ford, who once had a website that covered the adult film industry. Quote, "There's a pretty common dynamic of women in this industry choosing boyfriends who abuse them." So true. So true. And again, if you want to read this for yourself, check out mercurynews.com. It's titled, "Mix of Porn, Drugs, Violence Leads to Suicide in Morgan Hill Motel." But let's finish this. It's good. 3 months before his death, Hoang was arrested by LA police on suspicion of pistol whipping Paige, then released for lack of evidence. It was disturbingly similar to the charges of kidnapping and beating an ex-girlfriend that had sent him to prison in the late 1990s. Most of these guys messing with these porn girls, the part of the reason that they target the women in the adult entertainment industry is because when an adult entertainer who's active, at least, goes to the police for help, a lot of times they'll ignore her because, you know, they're looking down their nose at her like, oh, she's just a little tawdry sex worker. Who cares? Which is why, over the years, there have been independent investigative bloggers and journalists who sometimes involve themselves with other things, such as myself, who act as watchdogs for that community. Some of you may wonder why I get trashed so much on the internet, because I stop a lot of the abuse that's going on. That's why. Consider the source of anything said about me. Anyways, the Paige-Huang marriage lasted scarcely longer than the time it would take to play Paige's 300 porn DVDs end to end. After a wedding, August 2nd, at a Garden of Love in Las Vegas, the two were husband and wife less than 3 weeks before Paige died in King City, apparently of a drug overdose at a motel room. According to online accounts, the coroner found minute traces of methadone in her body. So the husband later was found ODing of methadone, and this girl was found dead of methadone. He might have drugged her. He might have taken out some insurance on her and drugged her. It is not uncommon for porn stars to die shortly after they hook up with a guy or get married to him or are in some sort of a legal arrangement to where he could feasibly take out insurance on her. I always questioned that that was the situation when it came to August Ames. That was something strange going on with that guy, Kevin Moore. But anyway, interviewed by police about her death, but eventually released, Huang took a bus to Morgan Hill, where he checked into the Economy Inn. It might merely have been fodder for a police blotter or an adult-only publication. The thread started in 2006, more than a year before the deaths, with a picture of a semi-clad page signing a body calendar. Then, in the vicious style of web anonymous posters, critiqued Paige's body, prompting an angry answer from someone who seemed to be Paige herself. So even back in 2006, you had these online trolls bullying porn stars. And it's not uncommon. The ones that they bully most tend to be the ones who are often found dead of suicide or dead of some other means. That's part of the reason why you got these damn attorneys like Michael Fattorossi and Mark Randazza fighting so hard to retain the anonymity of these online trolls, because half of these online trolls doing this shit to girls should be in jail or dead themselves. And in time, things are going to change to where they don't get away with this mess anymore. When Paige's father, Ken Haley, joined the thread in September and announced that his daughter had died, the tone changed. I bet. Posting pictures of her funeral, Haley explained that he had not been aware until recently what Paige had been doing. Not uncommon. He and his wife were divorced, and the last time he had seen his daughter was in 2006. Haley downplayed a story, which he said was pushed by Chico Wang, that Paige was molested as a child by her uncle. Suddenly, strangely, he began getting condolences from Paige's fans. Quote, she really brought home the fact that she and other girls are humans and deserve so much better, end quote, wrote one, adding, quote, I'm incredibly sorry for your loss. Haley, 61, of Eugene, Oregon, responded with painful honesty, voicing regret that any of us who are parents might understand. Quote, she made choices that she was responsible for, yet she had few safety nets to keep her from falling into oblivion, he wrote. I feel remorse for not rescuing my daughter. Hindsight lays our hearts out to dry. We cannot escape opportunities lost. So this father of this porn star regrets that he wasn't more active in her life. And that's why it's very dangerous to not only not help your child if they've gone into the adult entertainment industry, but for people in that industry to be parents. I mean, I don't even think that they legally should be able to be. Truthfully, because you know something's going to happen. Something bad. Something just straight up disgusting. I've thought for years that quite a few males who are fathers in the adult entertainment industry specifically have children, especially when the children are with women from the third world, to sell into the underground slave trade for money.